view many as a constant. I view many as a certainty. I view many as a for sure thing. So many can come from many, many, many places, regardless of what's going on in the world. Many is not contingent on the economy doing well. Many isn't contingent on anything happening in any industry or any business at any time. Many is not contingent on anything. Someone's watching this in 10 years and the coronavirus is such a thing in the distant past, we all have an opportunity every minute of every day to go into worst case scenarios. We all always have the opportunity to go into all the bad what ifs. I can come up with bad what ifs for sure about like the economy gets worse and worse and worse and like no one has money and people don't buy anything including digital core. Like I don't know, I wouldn't go to the worst case scenario. For multiple reasons, but one main reason is all any of us can do ever is work with what we have today and where we're at today. So imagining that he might lose his job at some point in the future and you might be responsible for all the bills, not the vibe. If being responsible for the bills and you having the desire to pay all the bills easily and on your own and with ease is truly the core desire of your soul, then by all means create it. But the pressure idea and the projecting into the future vibe is not gonna serve you. The thing has always been to get clear on your desire. That's what do you actually motherfucking want here? You don't want him to lose his job. You don't want to be responsible for all the bills, I imagine. So let's not create that scenario and let's not put more focus and energy into an idea that you truly don't even want. I'm not saying if you worry about it, you'll create it. I'm saying anything we focus on, we give power to. Let's not give any power to a scenario that we're not trying to have in our life. Can you get out your journal and as though you're writing from a future place, talk about how well this season went from you? Can you be Tara in 3 months writing to yourself now and saying, thank God that everything happened exactly the way it did. I couldn't see it at the time, but the timing of the quarantine, the timing of things changing in the airline industry, it all worked in my favor. At the end of the day, this happened and this happened and this happened and this happened. Can your future self, who's already manifested some cool shit, talk down your current self and can you design the vibe of where you're going? Now, I'm not saying every time we design our future that exact thing happens in that way. I'm saying every time we design our future, we tap into the vibration of a potential outcome and we add more power to the outcome that we're desiring. And that would serve us all deeply right now. Like Amanda Francis should be writing about how Amanda Francis Inc. thrived in unprecedented, immeasurable and unmeasurable ways that like at this time, my company did things that no one ever could have imagined was gonna be possible in an economic downturn or in a recession or in a what the fuck ever. It's normal to be worrying about people. It's normal to be worrying about sickness. It's normal to be feeling for the hospital workers. It's normal to be wondering what you can do and to do everything you can. Like all of that kindheartedness that we possess, that is a vibe. Focusing on how this is gonna destroy our life, not a vibe. Not a vibe. Not a vibe. It's like, I talk about it in so many ways, in so many different forms, over different courses over the years, but like, it is always about turning shit into gold. It is always about taking something that didn't look so good and doing amazing things with it. Now, do things have to get shitty to create gold? No, we can just create gold because that's who we are. But when things begin to look shitty, let's decide to turn it around. Let's decide to create gold. Let's decide to do something good with what we've been given. And I've been so proud of and impressed with how people are figuring out how to innovate. Even though they're afraid and even though they're nervous and even though they really don't know what the outcome's gonna be on some of this. I mean, don't get me wrong, like I said, we get to choose our outcome. But I'm talking about people that I'm not teaching in Money Mentality Maker. I'm talking about people I know in the world. Like my hairstylists are a great example. They left their salon. They were about to open a new salon and quarantine happened and they're teaching online education every day on hairstyling The woman is my colorist and the husband cuts my hair, and they're a team. Tim and Tab collab. If you want to follow them, you can look at the hashtag Tim and Tab collab. And she's doing a color tip every other day, and he's doing a cut tip on the off days. And they're building this massive online audience as online hair educators. What I said to both of them is, you're making the right moves right now. You're building an audience. This is amazing. People love you. They love your content. You're being stable and reliable for them, showing up every day with your live streams. They know you, they like you, they trust you. And because they're asking me, do we do a membership? Do we do an online course? What do we do? And I was like, there's a million things you can do. But what I would do first is sell a one-time offer, a one-time training, all the things we couldn't say on Instagram Lives, and let people get used to paying you. Let them practice paying you. Let them see what it feels like to pay you and receive beautiful content. That's step one. And then you're in a really great position for a course or a membership or whatever. Not that everyone has to do a one-off training before they can do a course. It was just what I felt led to say to them. The point being is, they've always wanted to be online and they've always wanted to do more education. And now this situation has kind of forced them to, and they would love to be building up clientele in their new salon. And they can't do it directly right now, but I am for sure that they are indirectly doing it by showing up on online every day and being seen as even more of experts in their field. So there's a couple women who have nail salons and do nails in my courses. One messaged me yesterday because she's selling kits to get your gel nails or your acrylic nails or your dip powder nails. I have dip powder on my real nails. Selling kits on how to get the fucking shit off our nails. Thank God, it's a resource, it's needed, and she's doing it. And on our Insta story yesterday, she's at the post office shipping out all these kits to fix our nails. And I'm like, praise the Lord for you. The point being is, it seems like we're restricted. It seems like we don't have options, and it is just not true. It's a weird time, it's a confusing time. You're definitely probably gonna pick up on various energies. All of that's fine. It's still a unique time to choose to focus on what you want and to create. And that is just wildly true. And there's just nothing more fucking true than that. You still have power. You still can create. You can still do all the things. But I wouldn't try to make the bad feelings stop. I would just acknowledge, I feel bad right now. This feels like shit. And then I would do something to help myself feel better. You can be in a bad mood. You can be a bitch. You cannot have your life together. You can feel grumpy and horrible and like the world is going to shit and still be rich. Not related at all. They're only related because we have them all linked up. So I view money as a constant. I view money as a certainty. I view money as a for sure thing. So like yesterday, I woke up super grumpy. I was in a bad mood. I was so irritated. I was annoyed at everyone, like bad fucking mood. And like, I really wanted to feel better. I really wanted to turn it around. Like I changed my attitude. I changed my disposition. I felt better. But none of that was so I could make money. Money is a constant in my life. Money is part of my way of being. Money is part of my way of conducting myself and seeing the world and using my gifts and creating resources. Money is. Say it with me. Money is. I was thinking about today, what has changed in the 2 years since the last module? The last module, I was making about $250,000 a month. And present day, my biggest month is $460,000. It would be safe to say that the company range right now is between $360,000 and $460,000. And so what's changed in the time from then to now? Fucking nothing. Besides, I trust myself more to earn and receive. I trust myself more to have. I trust myself more to be with money. I've just gotten more confident and solid in what already was, what was always available, but what I've been creating for a long time. It just feels solid. It just feels certain. If you're into like masculine and feminine energy, it feels like a rock solid masculine presence of love and support and stability in my life. Like money just is. Okay. So that being said, do you want to feel like shit? No. Do you have to feel like shit? No. But does feeling like shit mean you're fucking with money? No. Because, like, I have to teach you how to feel feelings of already having money, and I have to teach you to work on your limiting beliefs with money, and I have to teach you how to access the vibration of abundance, and all of that is my job. But beyond all of that, after you do all of that, money can just be. It can just be there. It can just be consistent and reliable and stable in the way it fucking is. I'm even more solid in my belief of how money gets to be for me. It's even more certain and steady and stable. Does that make sense? And there's nothing I can do to fuck that up. That is how it gets to be, and that is what is available for me. There's so many different schools of thought around like how life works and the world works and how we receive money and how we're taken care of. And I have no problem with any like government assisted kind of thing or any like loans or any helpful programs that like help people get through a difficult time. Like all of that is fine, but it's just not the only way. And I shame no one that has needed to use those programs or will need to use them, or if it's the right fit for you at the right time and you qualify, by all means, that's a way to receive money. But that's not how I primarily think or live or be or conduct myself. I feel so responsible for me. I feel so responsible for myself, my wealth, what I create, what I receive. I live in a pretty empowered place around like, if something needs to change, if something needs to be done, if more money needs to be made, that's up to me. So no one needs to save me, because I can choose to receive money, I can choose to earn money, I can choose to generate wealth, and I can choose all those things. That being said, I don't think money that comes from a program meant to help people is not valid money. That's completely valid money, and there's nothing wrong with that. So money can come from many, many, many places, regardless of what's going on in the world. Money is not contingent on the economy doing well. Money isn't contingent on anything happening in any industry or any business at any time. Money is not contingent on anything. I hope you learned how to tap into the frequency of money's here for me. Money desires to support me. I am loved. I'm appreciated. I'm supported by money. I can tap into the frequency and the feeling of money. I can think thoughts of already having money. I can feel feelings of already having money. I can live in that place, and from there, always be inspired to the right actions and the right steps for me to receive more. And that, for me, that foundation and that belief system just transcends anything that could be going on in the world or any like doomsday-y predictions. That being said, I'm not ignorant to what's going on. I care a lot about the economy. I want the economy to be stimulated. I want commerce to move forward. I want people to be able to buy, sell, give, serve, and like exchange goods, and I want all of that to continue. But while it's halted, that doesn't mean that I'm not responsible for my wealth anymore, that I can attract and receive how I desire. So does that make sense? You're still responsible, you're still capable, and you do not need anyone to save you. That being said, if there is something out there that can help you or bring you relief, I think that's cool too. There's nothing wrong with it. Okay, I'll talk to you soon. Have a lovely day.